Not everyone gets the same results in the recovery from their head injury. Why is that? And the sad fact is that most people never even make a full recovery. Immediately, I think of people like the great Muhammad Ali, who ended up suffering from a debilitating case of Parkinson's disease, or Aaron Hernandez, who turned homicidal and eventually suicidal, and people like Pritchard Colon, the boxer who ended up suffering from severe brain hemorrhages after his fight, as well as Junior Seau, who was loved and adored by so many and ended up tragically killing himself. It makes you think, what if they were able to get the help that they needed and deserved? Hopefully, what happened to them doesn't have to happen to you. That's why in today's video, I'll explain three dynamic and science-backed methods you can use to heal your brain injury, the neuroscience and mechanics behind a hit to the head, and why so many people never seem to get better after it. By watching this entire video, you'll be fully equipped with information and resources to take steps into your recovery. Before I take you into the steps to recover, we all have to agree and understand what happens to the brain during a brain injury. As a brain injury and brain surgery survivor, I understand it's how important it is to understand what we are dealing with before we dive into the how and the why. Quite simply, when you hit your head or an object hits your head, the brain jolts back and forth very rapidly. This causes three primary reactions to happen. Number one, because of the rapid movement, it causes countless numbers of micro tears to pulsate through the neural real estate of your brain. Your brain takes notice and the inflammation process begins. And depending on the severity of your injury, hemorrhages occur and even brain bleeds. And number two, communication is severely disrupted. Imagine for a minute if you were beat down and thrown in a dark basement and locked away without a key. Of course, you would be scared shitless and you would feel really isolated because you couldn't talk with loved ones or neighbors. And in order for the brain to be healthy and work at its best, brain regions, and especially neighboring brain regions, need to communicate effectively. And when you hit your head, this makes chatting very difficult, especially at first. Just how a car has an engine that powers it, cells have organelles called mitochondria that serve as their powerhouses. When you hit your head, it is a huge stressor, not only to the brain, but the rest of the nervous system as well. In order to deal with that stressor, the brain kicks into full survival mode. Inflammation levels rise and resources such as oxygen and blood flow are sent to the injured areas. The mitochondrial production of your cells in your brain is diminished because they are busy working. It's kind of like a closed down construction site that you don't have access to. Because mitochondrial production is impacted, the production of adenosine triphosphate, also known as ATP, is as well. This influences how much energy your brain and nervous system can produce. And due to this, you will feel sluggish, suffer from brain fog and mood swings, and really not feel like yourself for a while. Now that we covered some basics about what happens to the brain during a concussion, let's move on to the fun part. Here's how you can heal a concussion by using these three powerful science-backed methods. Number one, meditation. Now don't get scared or turned off because I feel wholeheartedly that meditation saved my life and my recovery from multiple concussions. My favorite Harvard-backed study found that in only 56 days of meditation, that's 8 weeks, that the physical structure of the brain will change, meaning that enough new neural connections will form that there is tangible and physical evidence of change in your brain. That's huge, especially if you have hit your head, because remember, we are trying to repair your brain from the damage it had suffered. For me, there's no better way to do that than simply closing your eyes, cutting out the outside world and stimuli, and taking some deep, concentrated breaths.
Now, I may be a little biased, but I did my PhD research on the efficacy and impact that mindfulness meditation had on traumatic brain injury.
In the research, we found in a case study of 10 random people, huge recovery results and only 2 months of mindfulness meditation that was practiced consistently.
While conducting the study, we found there were drastic decreases in discomfort levels associated with headaches, brain fog, anxiety, guilt, depression, frustration, fear, nausea, and insomnia for all study participants.
Unfortunately, meditation is a very misunderstood topic because it is a very broad category. Because there's so many categories, you will need to do a little exploration and find a type of meditation that works and resonates with you the most in your recovery. Number two, nutrition, nutrition, nutrition. Like my good friend Kevin Ballister from How to Feed a Brain explains, nutrition is like the building blocks and essentials to our brain. Think of it similar to like you are building a bridge. In order to build it, you would need the supplies necessary to do so. You could have the best skilled workers and machinery in the world, but if you don't have the supplies to build the bridge, it'll never get built. So think of the workers as the targeted exercises for the brain and the nutrition as the supplies. Here is a list of 10 of my favorite delicious and nutritious brain foods. Number one, eggs that are packed with protein and choline, which helps support memory and cognitive functioning. Number two, fatty fish, which is full of omega-3 fatty acids and is great for brain health and your mood. And number three, broccoli. This is full of vitamin K, and even if you look at it, it kind of looks like a brain. Number four, dark leafy greens like spinach and kale. Eat your spinach like Popeye says because they're full of vitamins and minerals. Number five, sulfur-rich veggies like garlic, onions, and cauliflower provide sulfur, which supports neurotransmitter function in the brain. Number six, avocados are loaded with healthy fats and nutrients to support the functioning of your brain. Number seven, blueberries, or you can call them brain berries, which are full of antioxidants and flavonoids that can help improve memory. Number eight, nuts and seeds like almonds, walnuts, and cashews, which are full of healthy fats that help reduce inflammation and support your brain's functioning. Number nine, turmeric. This incredible spice is full of anti-inflammatory compounds, and that helps reduce inflammation as well. And number 10, last but not least, dark chocolate, my favorite, which is full of antioxidants and mood-enhancing compounds. Also a bonus, which you can't forget, which isn't a food, but it's so important, which is good and delicious hydration of purified water. Your brain is close to 60 to 75% water, so you are what you drink as well. Number three, deep diaphragmatic breathing exercises. Deep breathing and breath holds, bar none, are going to help you recover faster than almost anything. Remember I told you that we need good nutritional supplies? Well, deep breathing helps you bring those supplies to where they need to go in the form of blood flow and oxygen so that you can make a full recovery. Understand that a concussion is a huge stressor to your brain and nervous system. Take a look at this graph. The huge stressor of brain trauma knocks us way, way out of homeostasis. But deep breathing is like Superman because it stops stress in its tracks. Believe me, try combining deep breathing with some deep breath retention exercises and meditation, and you will have a very peaceful time. So to finally answer the question, why most people don't recover from their concussions is because of the fact that they didn't know about the idea in the science of neuroplasticity. Knowing that simple idea alone will give you hope, because your brain needs hope that it can survive and it can thrive. And once you have that idea, there's so many different protocols that you can use to begin to heal your brain on a day-to-day basis. So that idea alone is how I went from being a fat drug addict and slob that had a criminal record to becoming a doctor with his PhD. And you can do the same too, my friend. Now that we're wrapping up this video, I want to give a huge high five to you. Let's work together and find a unique and proper solution for you to recover as fastly as possible. And if you are extremely motivated to get the best help possible, I invite you to apply to work with me one-on-one, also in the description. And now for a limited time only, we're offering an early bird discount of 50% for our new fantastic 12-week Rebound Your Brain program which is starting on May the 15th. Hurry up, because I'm fairly selective of who I work with and I only have 4 spots left at the moment. Apply by clicking the link down below. Thank you so much for watching my video, and I hope that you like, comment, and subscribe and share this to other brain injury survivors. Let's boost the hell out of this algorithm. Have a wonderful and blessed day, and I'll catch you on the next video.